not when you listen for just a minute. My God, now you asked for it. I'm telling you.
But I want it.
You're out pacing. You're racing your motor. You God damn it. You've got this thing in the bag.
I'm just enjoying my friend.
They can't possibly beat you. But I tell you what you're doing. You are trying to do too much.
No, I'm not. You know all I've done? I worked on the budget. And I
said, you promised this to the old dope yet?
But I'm not going to lay out. At least like he said he was. Go ahead.
You're trying to do too much. And you're racing your motor. And you're drinking too much. And you're not sleeping enough.
Oh, no. Listen now, my friend. All that's wrong. I'll tell you what I'm doing. I had a quiet morning. I didn't come to the office until I waked up at 6:30. All my life, I waked up on a road gang, and I can't goddamn it. You get up early, don't you? You had to get through Oklahoma. You can't tell me you ever made the big leagues or not getting up early. It takes us a little longer than does some other folks. And I get up early, and I read all the papers. I read about 15 of them. But I read them in bed, and I'm relaxing, drink my tea, and go to the bathroom and watch the television. And then this morning, I won't tell you, this dust got around town, and my friend's really worried. I won't tell you why. I never enjoyed life more, never felt better in my life physically than I do now. At 12:45 today, I took Jack Valenti, Walter Jenkins, Bill Moyer, and I swam the length of that pool eight times today. I went down and had a hamburger. I came back and looked over my State of the Union. Called up, busted a fellow about $40 million, too much in a budget. And stretched out, took a little doze, lost consciousness, about 5 minutes on the couch. Came back and they said, now, are you in good humor? I said, yeah. Well, I said, we'll save you this, did you in a bad humor? And I said, what is it? Said, it's George Carmack's article. Said, we won't give it to you when you're in a bad humor. Well, I knew it was going to be bad if it's George's. And I read it, and he said that they always say that folks are not true to their reason. But Johnson is true to his reason. And he wrote the kindest, sweetest, nicest description. I'm going to send it to Dean Rusk, and Mac George Bundy, and all these sophisticated fellas. Andrew Biddle-Duke, he even compliments Andrew Biddle-Duke. I want you to read it, and
I'll catch it.
Then I read old man Dobie's letter, and the funny thing was Houston Hart wrote about it like George Carmack did for all of his papers, North American newspaper launch used it, but he said if there's ever a place where Andrew Biddle-Duke, the proper chief of protocol, was not needed, it was Stonewall, Texas. So I thought you would pay it. So I'm really, then I'm going over, I'm going to bed early. You know, I don't have anything to do at night. I can't go out. If I broke out twice, what I do is I go home and I have myself 2 or 3 highballs with my wife, and I have to sit there and read and work. I've got Indonesia. They wanted me to give them $35 million the other day, and I had to read on it till 2 o'clock in the morning. They came in and I had to have India 65, and I read on it till 2 and turned both of them down. But I just thought, what if I hadn't had the desire to read them? I'd be in a hell of a shape. But don't you think I'm overdone? If I am, I'll just come out. First time I feel real good and tired, and I feel like I'm overdone, and I'll call you and let you come over here and judge it to sit around eating. But Lady Bird, now, it's not like you were in the Senate where you got 100 people around you every night. We don't do that. I have lunch today with Walter Jenkins, and I was rather lonely. And I had a nice little rest. So don't you worry about me, and I'll guarantee to be more careful anyway.
Well, listen, there isn't anything, but you've made the goddamnest impact on this country imaginable.
Well, you just watch
everything my... Everything right, except watch yourself.
You just watch my budget message.